Hello, guys.
Hello. Buenas tardes.
Hola, hola.
Congratulations on the win. How do you feel?
I feel great. I came in shape. I came prepared. 6 months of non-stop work. And I was asking for a fight since January, believe it or not. And later but sooner came, and now we're here. I'm pretty happy about the fight and the result.
And it was a rematch. So can you kind of explain to us how different it felt, or maybe how similar it felt?
Is definitely different on a regular fight, just because the fact that you already fought the guy, you guys felt each other's energy for 15 minutes back in the day. But you know, both of us are completely different fighters. You know, it's many years ago. I fought like what, almost 15 times since, and he's coming off three. He was coming off three wins, and it was a dangerous fight. You know, because it was one of those fights that mentally I was like, I'm supposed to win this fight, and that shit is not that easy when the odds are like that in your mind. So I just came in there and, you know, fought hard, stay disciplined, and bring the win home.
So did it almost feel like a completely different fighter?
Not really. Like, he keeps winding the same way his punches. Like, he's a guy that is easy to hit, but the problem is if you miss, he's throwing bombs at you, and that's how he finished the last two guys. They kind of forget about it, and they were popping him, and, you know, they just eat a bomb and went to sleep. So the guy is dangerous, so I wasn't there to, like, you know, be cocky or disrespect the guy, because you get punched in the face, you're fucked.
Was there anything that surprised you about him this time around?
He was moving a lot. Last time he came at me, but, you know, last time I was pretty green too. It was my third fight. I was training in Ecuador, so, you know, this time my game plan was just walk him down and make him pay at any moment, and sure I did.
And you said you were trying to get a fight since January. How fast do you want to get it back in there now? Are you wanting to take a little bit of a break?
No, there's no breaks. I'm gonna go back to the gym next week, and, you know, I'm not gonna go crazy. I'm not gonna spar on Tuesday, but, you know, there's things you can work on. There's things you can get better, and there's always room for improvement. So that's what it's all about for me. And if they find me a good fight in the next couple of months, I'm gonna be ready to go.
And what are your things you want to improve on?
Everything, you know, just stay sharp, stay in the gym, and, you know, don't forget what brings me here, that is hard work. So a lot of people forget about that, and then you get fucked up, you know. I'm not planning on that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Were you surprised how much punishment he was able to take?
Yeah, like, he was taking a lot of damage, and sometimes, you know, fuck, like, the elbow rocked him because I felt his leg giving up in the stand-up. Then a couple of the jabs hurt him because I saw his eyes getting weird. And then in the ground, those elbows were pretty solid because there were more than three cuts in his head. And the guy is tough. He can take a punch, and, you know, and I have the gas and to do that for 25 minutes or more.
Is there anyone in particular you would like to fight?
I would like to fight with Cruz. You know, it's not like I'm dying for the fight, but I think it makes sense. But anybody in that top 10 till the top 5, I would love to fight. You know, since they give me this rematch, I'll be willing to fight Aldo again, but I don't think he will do it, since he wrote it before the fight. Last time he declined a 5-rounder, so I think he knew it. But fuck it, I take the loss like a man, I get better, and I was able to do that today. You know, I take the guy down and stay there with the elbows. You know, why not win like that?
For what it's worth, Cruz on the TV, he said that he respected you for looking up, but he also wants to look up.
I respect him for that, but, you know, the UFC might call him for the fight, you know. We will see. If I'm not wrong, they called him before, after my fight with Sonja Dunn, and I believe he declined it, so we'll see what happens. I'm going to fight anybody at any time, so they know me.
Congrats, man.
Thank you, brother.
Marlon, ¿puedes explicarnos un poco por qué escogiste esa canción con la que saliste?
Me gusta el reggae, me gusta mucho el reggae, y esa canción fue la que me prendió para esta pelea en particular. Yo siempre cambio de canción en todas mis peleas, siempre busco una canción nueva, ¿no? A veces la gente quiere algo, la gente pide algo, pero no es lo que le haga sentir bien a la gente, el que se va a trepar a las jaulas soy yo.
Felicidades en el triunfo, Chito. Ya que has trabajado ahí con el UFC, comentarista, ¿esto te ha ayudado en tu juego? ¿Has podido mejorar ya siendo, estar detrás de la pantalla, aparte de en la jaula?
Sí, realmente ayuda mucho el estar comentando las peleas, porque ver las peleas en vivo, puedes ver a los peleadores cuando se quiebran, cuando hay que acelerar, y en esta fue una de esas peleas, ¿no?, en las que había que apretar un poquito el acelerador y hacer más puntos, hacer un poquito más de daño a tu oponente y seguir empujando hacia adelante, ¿no? Porque si no tienes la experiencia que has visto eso, es algo nuevo para ti.
¿Era parte de del plan empezar un poquito lento? Porque se vio que claramente ya te prendiste para el segundo y tercer asalto.
La parte del plan era usar mucho el jab y presionar, pero él estaba tirando muchos golpes fuertes, entonces tenía que también cuidarme. Pero realmente hay situaciones a veces no quieres arriesgarte mucho, y sé que tengo el tanque de gas para empujarlo en dos asaltos, así que quería mirar la fuerza, la velocidad, porque el que tenía más que ganar en esta pelea es él que yo. El que está en los rankings soy yo, entonces tenía que ser un poco más inteligente que él y así lo hice.
Ok, y has mencionado que quieres eventualmente llegar al título. Si no te dan a Cruz, ¿aceptarías una pelea si te la ofrecen para julio, agosto, o a fuerzas quieres ranking de los mejores 10?
Pues ya hay parte del UFC, ¿no? Ellos me van a llamar con un nombre y vamos a ver qué sale.
Idealmente, ¿quién quisiera? Si te dieran la opción, claro, no siempre sucede, pero vamos a decir, Chito, pelea estelar, 5 rounds contra...
Me parecería una buena pelea con Cruz, con Moraes, con cualquiera que esté por el número 8, el 5.
Ok, de acuerdo. ¿Lesiones? ¿Algo que te molestó hoy o nada? Lo siento.
Por ahí un par de golpes, pero nada que no se cure con hielo y whisky.
Muy bien, felicidades.
Thank you, gracias. Thank you, guys. Oh, go.